You are also proposing mandatory testing for certain sectors for HIV, any particular sector, or is this for just for the department?
That has been in our catalog of interventions because we want to be ahead of the virus before it spreads into the general population. But of course, there are AIDS lobbyists that would say that it should be voluntary. Let's respect patient rights.
But you're proposing mandatory testing exactly for whom? Is there any particular group?
It's an opt-out mandatory testing. Mm. It's offered to you when you visit any facility, for example, and you can opt out. You can say no, but it's actually offered.
I see. Okay, so
it's not mandatory.
It's mandatory to inform you.
So it's mandatory to inform
just
you.
To tell
every yes, time you to offer you, and if you opt out, then.
Okay. And you are in favor of this kind of program?
Honestly, I have no real opinion on the matter because I already know my status. Yeah. Mm. And I'm very lucky that I have family, friends, work that accepted me even when I was diagnosed. Mm. But I also know that there are people who, because I'm public, they look for me on social media, they message me the moment they get a diagnosis or the moment they have fears that they might have it. And sometimes I would talk to these people and it would take me 6 months just to get them to take a test. Mm. And then I've been talking to human rights, other HIV advocates and lobbyists, and they're telling me that, because I was very open to mandatory testing, but it's easy for me to say since I'm already, but they were telling me that the reason why this becomes problematic is because we don't have a culture that is open and accepting. So if someone is forced to take the test, they might not be ready for the results. Mm.